let the real deal now. Gonna kick your sorry ass out on the street. Is that what you got? You used to think you owned the street. We're back to back and your ass is dead meat. Victory is sweet.
Bring it on.
Here's a receipt.
Bring it on.
What you gonna do about it?
Bring it on.
Is that what you got?
Bring it on.
And what you gonna do about it?
Bring it on.
Gonna kick your sorry ass, but what you gonna do?
Was just sitting on my sofa. Now the weight of the world's upon my shoulders. Average men became soldiers the day the robots took over.
Unplugged.
Before the machines get a hold of you.
Unplugged.
You flip the switch, but who's controlling who?
Unplugged.
Before the machines get a hold of you.
Unplugged.
You turn it on, but who's controlling who?
Unplugged.
Before the machines get a hold of you.
Unplugged.
You press the buttons, but who's controlling who?
Unplugged.
You press the buttons, but who's controlling who?
Unplugged.
You press the buttons, yo, my GPS froze, I can't get directions. I need Google or Siri just to answer questions. I change the channel every 10 seconds. Can't function if I lose my internet connection. Out of my zone, if I lost my phone, I wouldn't even know the number to my mama's home. And even if I have a...
Yeah, hello, 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 hello. How you guys doing? Welcome to Up Up Down Down. I am Austin Creed, and over here to my right, we got T Breezy up in the corner, looking.
Hello.
Interesting.
Really interesting.
The yellow tint glasses with the hands put together.
They keep the blue light out of my eyes.
Which is great.
Yeah, it's great. Less strain on the eyes. And actually, it sounds funny because it doesn't sound like it would actually work. But they make it so you don't get tired from like watching TV or playing games.
Or doesn't it also do the you're not supposed to be in front of screens for like 2 or 3 hours before you go to bed. And it blocks that bad stuff.
That's right.
Nice.
But the biggest thing for me, because I use these when I was driving too, like at nighttime when we drive from town to town, I would use them, and like, you know how you get drowsy as you're driving?
Mm-hmm.
I would not get drowsy. My eyes would not get fatigued.
Really? That's a lot.
It's crazy. Big, like, night and day difference. Legit. Legit. Not just a myth.
That's a lot. That's huge. Well, good thing. Just dropping information on this new year. Happy New Year, everybody.
Happy New Year. Out there. Happy New Year.
Appreciate you joining us on the the very first Tuesday night heat of 2024.
Ooh, good call, good call.
I haven't said the year yet. That's weird.
2024.
Yeah, how long does it usually take you to write it correctly?
I don't know, at least like a week or two. I'll probably mess it up a couple times.
It's a while. It's a while, yeah.
2024, so, wow.
Yeah.
I remember the year 2000. That was 24 years ago.
Don't even.
Dude, I do, that's, though.
That's
crazy. I remember I was playing NHL, I think it was NHL 2000.
Yeah.
But it was on PlayStation. Played it till like 11:30, walked over to this pizza joint. Midnight, everybody expected Y2K to go down. It didn't go down. The crazy part is that 18-year-olds and who would it be? 18 to 24-year-olds don't understand what Y2K was.
Oh, yeah.
They've never heard of it.
Oh, that's so weird. That's so weird. So it's funny. I feel like we talk about this regularly because as we're getting older and hopefully more mature, there's so many things that are retro now. So somebody was like, oh, yeah, that retro stuff. And I was like, retro? They're like, yeah, like PS2. I'm like,
ah. Yeah.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
It's happening.
Like our retro is like NES, and their retro is PS2.
Yeah. It's an ouch, no cap, we're so old.
No cap.
Okay, so we're starting off 2024 by playing Texas Chainsaw Massacre with you guys. If you've been here before, you know how it works. Breeze and I'm only passable with Leatherface, kind of. Our plan was to get down here, get on the game for like 30 minutes before we started so we could refresh our minds. That didn't happen because I was trying to fix audio and all that business. But Texas Chainsaw Massacre, we fired it up and there's new victims. Or there's a new victim, Danny, a new family member.
And a new family member.
Nancy. And we are going to play with you guys. Breeze, you switch back and forth between the family and the victims, yeah?
Do you not?
No, I just play Leatherface.
No, you gotta do victims sometimes.
I mean, it's fine. We'll do that today.
We gotta do it.
I was mad because last time we played, because we played all those games and then you didn't get any experience, and it's like, oh, because they're custom lobbies.
Oh, that's right.
I was hot. Okay. I'm joining right now. So if you've got the game, it's cross-platform, right?
It is.
Yeah.
And we don't have to play custom games. We can get some experience. So if we get a party,
we can get
a party and then join a game.
Ooh.
And then get some experience.
Nah. Because for what? Because then once we're customizing things, that's going to take me forever to customize my stuff. And I don't like customizing on stream.
Well, don't customize on stream, but we got to build some points here.
I feel like that's an off-stream thing to do.
It's not an off-stream thing, and you know it ain't gonna happen. There's not that much time in a day. We won't. We'll time you here, like on brands. You know what I mean?
But no, that's too much.
Relax.
That's too much. I don't like that pressure. I don't like that pressure at all.
I'm gonna. I need two more people in the party. I'm gonna give you guys the code here.
I'm playing this family.
Six, 7, 2. Oh. YZ9.
Wait, you leave the party. Oh, okay. Well, we need to make a room. We need to make a lobby. Or you want to play against real, like against other people? You want to play for real?
I want to get some points.
Oh man. All right. I just forget the buttons.
That's fine. We'll remember as we played.
All right. What's the code again?
The code.
Yeah.
We're already good.
Okay, we're set.
We got peeps in. So you said we're going to do family first?
Yeah.
All right, here we go.
Well, we can't because we have four now.
No.
Yeah.
No, we have three.
No, it's me, you, and two other people. That's four people.
Then we play. Oh, no, one of them would just join to the other side.
Okay.
Yeah. So family or victims?
Family.
Family.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, you can only match make family with less than
three people. Go victims in.
Victims.
See?
Good call. Sorry, bud.
No, and you're not sorry. Tell it to the judge.
It's true.
Bro.
Judge Dredd.
Oh, Judge Dredd, great movie. When they rip that dude's arms off and the Kool-Aid blood sprays everywhere.
Good movie, good movie.
Also, these Oreos.
You have just been plowing through Oreos, bud.
No, I have like 4 or 5 like every other day.
Okay. Every time that we're on, you have Oreos.
And we've been on.
We've been on.
Every like 2 or 3 days.
So you've been plowing through Oreos.
No. So in the past like 8 days, I've had 15 Oreos.
That's a lot.
Over 8 days?
Yeah.
No, it's not.
I can't remember the last time I had an Oreo.
So? That doesn't mean it's a lot of Oreos just because you don't eat them. It's not a lot.
15 over 8 days?
Over 8 days?
That's more than 2 Oreos a day. Don't break it down.
There's so many things.
It's like 1.5 Oreo a day.
I get up in the morning. I go to the gym for like 2 hours. I run around chasing kids all day. I can have 3 or 4 Oreos every couple of days.
I'm not scolding you for having Oreos. I'm just saying you're plowing through Oreos.
I'm not plowing through them. If I was plowing through them, I'd be plowing through like a sleeve of Oreos.
Plowing through a little bit.
You should just eat some Oreos, dude.
No, thank you. I have no interest.
Who in the chat? You know why I got back on Oreos? I hadn't eaten an Oreo for a long time. Because I saw that somebody can make... You know what mug cake is? I didn't know this was a thing.
Oh, yeah, you were talking about this mug cake.
Yeah, so people make cake in, like, coffee mugs. But if you take 4 Oreos, crush them up to, like, as much as you can, add some milk, and then put it in the microwave, it just turns into Oreo cake. And it's pretty good. Obviously, you can add whatever else you want to it for a little bit more flavor. But I got that so we could do it at the house, and we did it. And after, like, the 3rd or 4th time we got it right, and I was like, well, now we have this pack of Oreos here. And we were streaming that night, and so I had...
Wait, so now you've been plowing through Oreos and Oreo cake.
I'm not plowing through anything. Well, the matchmaking didn't work.
Where did you go? You left, that's why.
No, I didn't leave. It said it didn't work.
You're not in the party anymore.
I know. It said matchmaking did not work, and it kicked me out.
It's because you left, that's why.
I didn't leave. I got kicked out.
You canceled it. You canceled it.
You kicked me out. I can't cancel it. Only you can cancel it.
I can't.
I'm going to eat this Oreo.
Join in. Plowing through Oreos. I'm going to create a lobby. Mm-hmm. All right, invite people to the. I do not want to be Leatherface.
I want to be Leatherface.
I want to be Connie.
Take my request. Hell yeah.
Relax, but also I want to be Danny, the new guy.
I'm about to crush your playing family, or are you playing victims?
I'm gonna play victim.
Sharper, you can do that exact thing literally with any box cake mix. Mix plus milk equals cake. See, I didn't know this.
The code, by the way, 4ZTPWP.
I saw the Oreo thing, and then people were telling me, oh, that's just like a mug cake. And I was like, what is mug cake? And I'm realizing for all intents and purposes, like I'm like by definition like an adult, but I don't feel like it.
What did you just say?
Intents and purposes.
Intents and purposes.
That's it, right?
That is it. But yeah. I've heard people say intensive purposes.
That's very wrong.
Really? For all intents and purposes?
I think so.
it sounds passable, but it's intents and purposes.
Yeah, because this is my intent and purpose. Mm. What would intensive purposes mean?
Well, for all the purposes. You know what I mean? Filling up here. We got the family. We need one more victim. Here we go. One more victim. 4ZTPWP.
I saw somebody was asking earlier why we're playing Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Because I really like this game.
And they just they got new downloads. Got to test it out.
Yeah. How many minutes in the microwave? We did 1.5. And it wasn't bad. The first one was not great.
What did it taste like?
The first one didn't taste good. It was like a...
It was just like burned? Like burned Oreos?
No, it was like kind of like goopy. Mm. But then by the time we made the third one, it was cake. But I think that just putting other stuff in it will make it a lot better.
Sure. There we go. We're full. Okay, we're let's full. Go.
Ready.
I'm ready, Dub, son.
Now I got to remember how to play this game.
Me too.
I will one day. We will play this. What and level up. Level up some.
You say that.
That's all we need to do.
And a new game will drop, and then we'll play that, and then we'll
we will. I so one of my resolutions this year is one, make an attempt to put as much positivity out into the universe as possible, and be a more calm and understanding person. I feel like that's
that's your New Year's resolution?
Yes, and in that, by calm, I feel like I get really frantic when games come out, and I want to like just like experience a little bit of it, then I'll go to the next one and experience some. But maybe like 3 months ago, maybe not even three, maybe like a month and a half ago, I was like, hey, there's a couple of games in 2023 that I didn't get to play. And so I sat down, instead of playing a bunch of games like here and there, I just would only play this one game until it was done.
Wow.
So I finished a couple of games in the past couple of weeks. One of them was Punch Club 2. Did you ever play Punch Club?
I did, yeah, you told me about it.
Okay, yeah. Punch Club 2, so good, dude. Let's see. Wait till it gets lawsuited like Friday the 13th did. This Friday the 13th got lawsuited? The game?
Yeah, that's why they had to quit playing it.
Oh, wow. Leatherface is angry. R2 is swing. L2. Red. Is it R1 to run with it? Nope, R1 turns it off. Okay. Let's see. Platinum the games if we're moving on. I can't. Only some games. Like Spider-Man. Okay. L1 is run. Here we go. Ah! Oh, I see you. I see you. I see you. I'm coming to get you. Ooh. I'm coming. I'm coming. Ooh. It should really let you get them through that little crack. Oh, I see you. I lost you. Oh, no, I didn't. I didn't. Oh, that's unfortunate for you. Unfortunate for you.
You getting somebody?
I'm getting you. Isn't that you?
That ain't me.
Oh.
That ain't me.
I got it. They call me Cuban Pete. I'm the king of the rumba beat. When I play in the rockers. I saw you, but I didn't move fast enough. Oh, I see somebody upstairs. I'm trying to creep. Oh, is this a different kind of basement?
This is a new this is Nancy's house.
Ah. Oh, you punched me. You dick. And he punched me so hard I got flustered. Somebody. Grandpa. I still say I want to be able to zoom out a little bit. That dang, that door is back open. It got me. Okay. You know what? Somebody wants to move, they better hit me. Okay.
Where are the doors, man?
Oh, get him. Get him. Oh, nice. Nice, she cut him off. Good, 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 good. Oh, he went down the hole. Okay. You go ahead and get him. Yeah. Where's Breezy at? Where's Breezy at?
Don't worry about where I'm at.
Where's Breezy at?
Don't worry about me.
Huh?
Don't worry about me.
Breezy.
Come on.
I forgot how nerve-wracking this game is.
It's a lot. It's who? Who's in the chat? Can I feed him some blood, please, Grandpa? Grandpa. Okay.
Oh, you killed somebody.
Ah, good. 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 So what characters would you guys like to see modded in this game? Dr. Evil as Leatherface? Yeah. Can y'all find us some mods? What is it? Up to...
Death doesn't have to be the end, you know.
Oh.
Just trust me.
Oh, she said somebody's out here. Okay. We got a problem out here? Is this door locked? Okay. Breeze, you know we're gonna find you.
Don't find me.
I don't know. Okay, I won't find you.
Do not find me.
Do not. I'm gonna find you. Give me some of this blood. Give me some of this blood.
You know what I really want to do?
Have some fun.
To like. I just want to figure. Oh god.
You get scared?
No. I just want to figure out what to do with like the valves, because I never know what to do with the valves.
Oh.
Like the valves and the what's the other thing?
Yeah, that would probably help you.
You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
The valves and the fuses. The fuses.
Are you upstairs or downstairs?
I'm not telling you.
Please. I don't believe you.
Why'd you ask?
I get stuck on these maps. Do you think it would help if I got
this? This is the first time on this map. We've never done this map.
Yeah. If I got a wider monitor.
I don't think so.
We got a problem, guys. Yeah, we gotta flip this. Okay, I see you guys think you're funny. You guys think you're cute, huh? Oh, okay. I see what you're doing.
What am I doing?
Dang it. How'd you get out?
Yeah.
How'd you get out?
There was a side gate.
With the electric fence?
We went by the generator and turned off the generator.
Yeah, I went over here and it said it was on cooldown.
Yeah.
Dang.
So the Danny guy is really cool. He can inspect and tamper with stuff. So it like keeps doors open and messes with like all the generators and stuff like that.
Whatever.
I like it. Like it.
So first game lucky.
Not lucky.
Very lucky.
You killed one person?
Yeah, I killed somebody. Immediately.
Okay. What was it, me?
It will be this time. No, we need to play on the same one this time. What do you mean what?
Same what?
Same team.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
What other same would there be?
True, true, true. You'd be a victim this time.
All right.
And then we'll both be family.
Okay. I just, when they punch Leatherface and he's stuck there in a trance for like 6 seconds.
Well, I mean, he's still human.
Yeah, but it's, I feel like Leatherface taking a punch from this random emaciated dude who's been on the run for a couple of days, like.
I don't know if he's emaciated.
I mean, he's not, he's no Leatherface.
I mean, true.
He's no Leatherface. All right. So if you guys played in this past game, jump out, and we're going to let some other people from the chat jump in.
That's right.
We'll go honor system on this. Go ahead and let people play throughout the night. And eventually, we will be able to crown a Cuban Pete. Cuban Pete is the MVP, the best person of the night, the best player of the night. No, Breezy.
I'm over to Nansan.
Breezy didn't get a fat dub.
I did.
No, he got
first,
he got
first game first
he got,
out.
He got very lucky.
Unbelievable.
He got very lucky.
Come on, man.
He said, "Why can't we kick Leatherface in the groin?"
I mean, he's not wrong.
Yeah, I mean, I guess you could. I thought, or you're going family.
I'm going.
You were going victims.
Oh, I'll go victims.
No, I picked Leatherface. Now you switched again. What do you want to do?
Going?
I'm
going
to go Leatherface.
Okay, I'll go
Okay,
Nancy.
All right. What's the code?
All right. Code is, same as before, 4ZTPWP.
4ZTPWP.
PWP, dude.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Did you see that Steamboat Mickey is public domain now?
Yeah, so I saw it, but I don't fully understand it.
So it runs out after X amount of time. Something
like them owning it runs out, you mean?
Yeah, so then people can do whatever they want with it.
Okay, so like Disney doesn't own Mickey anymore?
No, they own Mickey, but anybody can do whatever they want with Steamboat Mickey.
So when does it run out? Like after 50 years?
Something like that. So I guess.
That's how they did the Winnie the Pooh horror movie.
Yeah. So the new trend is whenever something goes public domain, people make a horror movie of it. What's the code again?
4ZT.
4ZT.
PWP.
PWP. Can you extend the amount of time? Okay, there's one more. Shady, one time.
And then we need one more person.
Yeah, so they have the Winnie the Pooh horror movie, and then there's already a Mickey horror project being made. They honestly probably start working on it before the copyright
is
done.
For sure.
And then when it drops, they're able to put it out there.
That's kind of crazy.
It's set 100 years after the creator's death, I believe. Oh, the public domain.
We need one more.
Can you extend it?
Nope.
Oh.
I think it just extends if we're not ready. Maybe?
Okay. You said OG Peter Pan became public domain too? Really? The demon?
Can you imagine?
Peter Pan.
Neverland horror story.
Is it? It already is a horror story.
It's not.
Yeah, it is. Oh, it makes us ready. Well, okay. All right.
Three on three.
Yeah, Peter Pan 100% is a demon.
Okay. Nancy's Nancy's made voyage here.
Okay. They got all the new outfits. She got the real 70s clothes. Oh.
Oh, this is doodle. Don't mind us. He's chopped in half.
All right, here we go.
Yeah.
Let's go, Leather. Let's go, Leather.
Nancy, ready to go, dude.
Ooh, Nancy's fast. I'm on the hunt.
Oh, cool, I can see like through the I can see through the vision.
What do you mean?
Like, I can see through the survivors, through the victims' eyes.
Oh, that's crazy.
Ooh, and I can add barbed wire in between little stuff so they can't get between it.
Oh, I like that. Okay, here we go. This is a 3-on-3 matchup. I am Leatherface. Breeze has selected Nancy.
She's the new one.
New to the game. Maybe, but when did they come out? I don't even know.
I don't know. I mean, newer, newest. I can't remember how to check, like, where the...
Tap up on the D-pad.
That tells you where Grandpa is and stuff?
Yeah.
And where the little deals are to get blood?
Yeah. Let's see, give me this blood.
Gotta wake up Gramps, dude.
So I told you I was watching Cobra Kai.
Yeah.
This weekend, watched all 5 Karate Kid movies.
Whoa.
Yeah.
And?
One, fantastic, obviously.
Sure.
2, incredible, obviously.
Wait, I don't know if I've ever seen 2.
You've never seen 2?
Karate Kid 2?
So the first one, I'm just going to go through them because it's spoilers. Anybody
first
in the chat
is the tournament. I know the initial with the tournament.
Tournament against Johnny Lawrence. Oh, I see you. Hold on. I saw somebody creeping. Yeah. I saw you. You better run. Oh, come on, baby boy. I got him. I got him over the thing.
I got him. Nice.
Yeah. I'll destroy this just in case. First one is great. Second one, it's like after the tournament, it's like 6 months later, I believe. Mr. Miyagi's dad is sick and is dying. And so he's like, I gotta go to Okinawa. Daniel is like, look, I'm gonna burn all my college tuition and go with you, which is insane. Buying a ticket to Okinawa the day of and dropping your college tuition. So. They go to Okinawa, they go to his village where he's from. Everybody there is super cool. But
I feel like I've definitely not seen this.
Maybe. It's complex, but it's good. So you find out Mr. Miyagi left his hometown because they did arranged marriages, right? And the woman that he was in love with was arranged to marry. Oh, door's open.
I know, I opened it.
Okay.
Oh no.
No, that's a
I opened
door.
Up I opened up the electrified one and shocked myself.
Okay. Nice. There you go. So he leaves because the woman that he's in love with and wants to marry is promised to his best friend. And so he tells the whole village, like, I don't care. I'm going to marry her. This is my girl. Huge dishonor to his friend, right?
Yeah.
His friend is like, bro, we got to fight to the death. And he's like, no, you're my best friend. I'm not fighting you. And so instead of fighting his friend and one of them dying, this door is open and somebody's upstairs. Instead of fighting his friend, he leaves and goes to America. So, and he's never been back home, right?
Oh, that's why he left.
Yeah, that's why he left. So he goes back because his dad is dying. First thing that happens is that kid's nephew, or that guy's uncle. Sorry, no, his nephew. Picks him up at the airport, brings him to the best friend. He's like, we gotta end this now. So that's kind of the crux of the whole movie. He's like, I'll give you time to see your dad, but then we're gonna fight to the death.
Whoa.
Long story longer, there's a huge, like, tsunami. Not tsunami, but a huge hurricane. All the people in the village are gonna get messed up. Daniel runs out and he saves this little girl who would have died, who's on a ladder. And the best friend looks at his nephew and is like, go help Daniel, who he's been a dick to the whole time, beat him up. He's like, I'm not gonna help him, screw that. And so Daniel gets over with everybody. The nephew is shamed. The next day, the hot girl in the village, who's Daniel's been macking on a little bit, is at the dance. Now the nephew comes in, is like, bro, we gotta fight to the death, screw you. They fight, Daniel beats him, they leave and go back to America.
Wow.
It's incredible.
Okay, so first one, obviously good. Second one, also good.
Second one, great.
Better than the first.
No.
What are you gonna say?
No.
Okay.
Not better, but like just as good.
Wow.
Third one, wild.
Wait, what's the third one?
The third one? Hold on. I killed one person. Did you get anybody yet?
No, I haven't even found anyone.
Okay.
I've been wandering around.
I'm trying to like actually play this, but I'm really focused on these recaps of Karate Kid.
I put all the barbed wire up, but now I ran out of barbed wire.
So okay. So third Karate Kid. They come back from Okinawa. Everything is fine. When they were in Okinawa, they were in a bar and these guys were breaking ice, sheets of ice that were lined up. So like you have to like swing across your body to break them. And all these army dudes were in there and they couldn't do it. Daniel goes in there and he's going to do it. But the guy's name is Chosen, the bad guy. He's like, bro, you can't do this. Mr. Miyagi comes in and he's like, Daniel, you can do it. What are the odds? Like 3-1. Mr. Miyagi puts like $600 down. Daniel focuses, breaks all five of the ice blocks that nobody could break. Holy crap, this is crazy. Now he's got all his college tuition back. Everything's fine, right? They come back to the States in 3. And I'm watching this because we watched Cobra Kai, just to reiterate. I cannot find anybody, jeez.
How many people? 2 people left?
Yeah, 2 people left. So in 3, they start off with Daniel. He's got his money to go to college. He goes, screw that. I'm going to put the money down to get Mr. Miyagi a building so that he can have a bonsai tree selling business, because that's his dream.
Oh, yep.
So they make this place. John Kreese, the one who was the leader of Cobra Kai in the first movie, was gone the whole second movie, right?
Yeah.
Where's Grandpa? So he comes back in the picture, and he shows up at his friend's house, who he knows from Vietnam. He's like, bro, I need some help. His friend is rich. He sends him to like Taiwan or something on vacation, but he's Cobra Kai too. He's like, dude, I got you. Everything's gonna be fine. He weasels his way into Daniel's life with this fake story and all this stuff.
Yeah.
He hires the bad boy of karate and he makes a contract with him. And he says, if you beat Daniel, somebody dying? Oh, somebody's fighting.
Really?
Oh, I don't know, but they got him. One left.
Okay.
He goes, you bring me an all-valley karate tournament championship, and I'll give you half of Cobra Kai. This guy is badass. He looks like Cody from Step by Step. Remember in Kickboxer?
Yeah.
He looks like that guy. So,
I see him.
Ooh, where?
You see him. Yellow is running.
Got him. Okay. I got eyes. He's down already, yeah?
He must be hurting.
I saw him on the ground, I thought.
I did too. He fell down.
Oh, he went down. Did he go down the well?
No, he didn't fall down a well. But he went somewhere.
Bro, he was over here with
yep.
Homeboy.
I saw it too. He was running and then he fell down, I think.
He looked like he was right in here. Step by Step was a good show. I swear I saw him.
He's gonna be swinging.
I feel like I hear him complaining.
He's around somewhere.
Oh, we're gonna find him. Oh, gotta be faster than that. Okay, so
this is green over here. He turn off the electricity of this thing. Get electrified again.
Okay, I'm gonna shut this down. Okay. So the guy that Kreese goes to get, his name is Terry Silver. This guy is a maniac. True maniac. He hires Mike Barnes to be the karate guy. Mike Barnes has to get Daniel to fight in the tournament because Daniel's not going to fight at first. And so he does so much horrible stuff to him. He almost kills him like 3 different times throughout the course of this movie. Finally, Daniel signs the thing that he'll fight. But Mr. Miyagi is like, bro, I told you not to fight. What's the point? So I'm not going to train you. Grandpa immobilized. That's not good.
Bye, Gramps. Bye, Gramps.
Okay, I'm running back.
Get in here.
But is he going to try to come to the...
I turned the generator on, so...
Okay, good.
He has to come back through here.
Good. Where is he?
Get back in here. He was just by Grandpa.
Yeah, but he's got to come through here.
That's only one exit.
Okay.
He ain't coming back here. We turn the generator on and we lock it up. Mm. He's in the house.
The call is coming from inside the house.
My barbed wire is still intact.
Leatherface is putting some miles in. Okay. So, they get Daniel to sign the thing, the application to be in the tournament. Miyagi won't train him. In comes Terry Silver again, who is Cobra Kai. He's like, bro, Cobra Kai messed up. They were bad to you. That's not what Cobra Kai is all about. Come train with me. I got you. So, he starts training him, right? One thing that Kreese, the evil Cobra Kai, tells him, he's like, I want his knuckles to bleed. So, he's convincing Daniel to, like, do his moves on this wooden robot-looking thing to where his knuckles are all bloody, his feet are bruised. He's beating the crap out of him. And then finally he realizes that he's turning into somebody he doesn't like because he punches some guy in the face when they're out at a party or something.
Yep.
Ooh, I see him. He's coming towards me. Hey, buddy.
I see ya.
He's at the container bridge. Oh, yeah, get him. Oh, he's down the well. He went down the well. Dang it.
Okay.
Leatherface is finishing his circles. Is that what it's called on the iWatch? The Apple Watch? Whatever. So, he's training the Cobra Kai, but then he doesn't like himself. And then they're like, wow, that was our big plan. But he's in the Cobra Kai dojo because he goes back to tell Mr. Silver, I can't do this. Yep. Silver is like, oh, I've been screwing with you from the jump. Here's Mike Barnes. He's like, oh, what? You're together? That sucks. What are you doing? Now as he's trying to leave the place, okay, that's you.
I'm gonna need you to find those.
As he's trying to leave the place, out jumps Kreese. These grown men are terrorizing this high school boy, this little boy. They beat him up some. Here comes Mr. Miyagi. He's like, fine, I'll train you. Beats the guys up. He fights Mike Barnes in the tournament. He ends up winning. End of the movie. Great. Hell of a movie.
Wow.
Next.
Where does it rank?
3 is very good. 3. 3, I think, is better than 2, but 1 might be the best. Because the only reason he beat Mike Barnes in the finals is because Terry Silver was like, I want him to hurt, make it go to overtime, and then beat him in overtime. Otherwise, Daniel would have got the crap kicked out of him.
Really?
There's no way Daniel beats Mike Barnes any day of the week.
Interesting.
And I can't find this guy. No. He went back downstairs. And I'm
downstairs searching for him. Oh, I see a door open.
Okay. I'm roaming all of the places, all his old hangout spots.
I feel like he's back. He's back upstairs. I feel like he's definitely upstairs.
I don't see anybody moving. And the generator is fine. The fuse box is fine. Does anyone have experience shipping large items across borders? No, sir. Abilities on. Said 2 had more story. 3 was back to just karate. Yeah, 2 did have more story, but 3, I felt scared for Daniel. 2, it was like, yeah, it's intense, and Chosen is a very good bad guy, and there's, like, stuff going on. But 3, I thought Mike Barnes was going to kill him. But then there's the next Karate Kid. Did you ever see that? No. Dang it.
Oh, come on, man. All
right. That was a long one.
Damn.
That was a long one. Okay, before we start, I got to get through this Karate Kid so I can concentrate. So, the next one is called The Next Karate Kid, and it's where Mr. Miyagi leaves California, goes to Boston, because his war hero buddy, the widower, her granddaughter is going crazy, played by Hilary Swank.
Oh, okay, so I have never seen it, but I remember it, like, as a thing.
One second.
But I never saw it.
My control speaker's turned all the way up. Okay. Sorry, one more time.
I said, so I remember that. I've seen, like, the front of the video or whatever, but yeah. I've never actually seen the video. I just remember it was with a girl.
It's trash.
Really?
And it's not because it's a female Karate Kid at all. Hilary Swank did a great job. Everybody in the movie did a great job. The story is just horrible. So,
did you like the ghost? Did you like Ghostbusters?
Yeah, I like Ghostbusters.
Do you like Ghostbusters too?
Yeah.
Did you like the Ghostbusters with the girls?
I didn't see it. I heard it was really good though.
I didn't watch it, but I watched the Ghostbusters after that, and it was very good.
I didn't see that one either.
Very good. You got to watch that.
I didn't watch the one with the kids because I hadn't seen the one prior to it, and I wanted to watch that before I jumped in the next one.
That was, I think, the one that I watched.
Okay.
It was the newest one, whatever the newest one is. And then they have another one coming out.
Okay, yeah, because which is a sequel to the one that just came out.
I believe so, yeah.
Here, look, I got to get through the next Karate Kid. It's horrible. It's a horrible movie. Everybody, okay, everyone in the movie did such a great job. And you know who's in the movie? Did you watch, who'd you say?
Hilary Swank.
Yes, Hilary Swank is in the movie. What's his name? Did you watch Righteous Gemstones?
I did not.
Did you watch Vice Principals?
No.
I don't remember what else he's in. But he's in a bunch of funny stuff with Danny McBride, but he's in the movie anyway. Mm. So the point is that it's trash because for the first, I don't know, hour of the movie, I think, if I remember right, there's no fighting. No fighting at all. The bad guys are some, like, coked out hall monitors, essentially.
What?
So she goes to school. She's got a hawk that had a broken wing that she's been taking care of.
Guys can join, by the way. Let them know the code. The code still 4ZTPWP. Anyone can join. Anyone can join. We got a minute and a half.
So she's got a hawk on the roof that she doesn't want people to find out about. These hall monitors that are led by this corrupt police officer are just like taking over the school, and they're just really mean. And so she's mean to like her grandma. Her parents passed away. So she's super angsty. So Mr. Miyagi takes her to like a monastery, and her dad taught her karate because Mr. Miyagi taught her granddad karate and got passed down. So she knows a little bit of it. So at this monastery, she like learns that she should be respectful and can deal with some of the stuff like with her parents passing. All of it's like very good stuff, but it's just like nothing about it is like karate tournament or life or death fight or like anything. It's just the story of this girl like using karate to like mentally get right, which again is great. But if you give me three movies of tournament, fight to the death, and then tournament, and then angry hall monitors, it's not the right progression.
Yeah, it's also, so you're telling me that it's, so there's Mr. Miyagi.
We gotta back out because we only have two and two.
Oh man. Three more going?
No, not in 20 seconds.
Okay. Creating a party. Mm-hmm. So Mr. Miyagi's in it.
Yes, Mr. Miyagi's in it, which he's great.
Is Daniel in it?
Daniel's not in it.
Garbage. is anybody from Cobra Kai in it?
No Cobra Kai.
Garbage. So it's literally just Miyagi and Swank and then nobody.
Yes.
Stupid.
Yes. So like...
Okay. Code, by the way, QLT9XT, just to get in the party and then we'll create a new lobby.
QLT9XT. So there's really no bad guy that the main person can fight. Like, if it would have been some like badass chick who is like beating the crap out of her for this whole movie, and then finally she has this big fight, but it's legit, it's like five dudes or like six dudes, right? Like five.
So what's like the ending resolution of this movie, like?
So the guy that she has a thing with, they're like beating him up, and so he goes to fight one of them because he bashes in their car with a baseball bat. he goes to fight one of them, and the all five of them gang up on him. And so she comes in to fight one of the guys one-on-one. She ends up beating him up. Then Mr. Miyagi beats up their trainer, or teacher, or whatever, and then they leave. But it's like, it's so it seems disappointing. Because everybody in it is so good and does such a good job, but the movie is just so, it's like it has nothing to do. I mean, it has something because karate is for the mind as well, but like.
The movie and the actors and the message, great, but just execution and storyline with the other Karate Kids, not good.
Yeah, not good.
I mean, when I think Karate Kid, I always think the tournament, you know, crane kick, sweep the leg, all that stuff.
Something. Give me something.
Yeah.
And then you have the Karate Kid, the new one with Jackie Chan and Jaden Smith, which is incredible.
Very good.
They literally took the original movie and they made the same movie, obviously, but they made it like so different to the point that it feels so good. It's not just like one of these random like rehashes of a movie series. Like it's so well done.
That's where I don't mind like a reboot, as long as it's got to be different enough.
Mm-hmm.
And I think they went different enough to like it fits into the Karate Kid family without kind of like sullying the name, you know?
Yeah. It was great, man. What's the code?
On this one, U8S78S.
U8S78S.
Did you ever watch The Three Ninjas?
Hell yeah, Tom Tom, that's my dude.
So I think there's several of them as well, but I don't think I've ever seen two, or if there's three.
I want to say there's at least two.
There's definitely two, because it was Three Ninjas Kick Back, and I never watched it.
Yeah. Ooh, sorry, I gotta address this. Someone says horrible. Come on now, it should have been the Kung Fu Kid, because he was doing kung fu, wasn't karate. If that's the sticking point, like I feel like you gotta loosen the collar a little bit.
Yeah, come on.
The fight scenes are great. The stories are great. The character development is great. Everything about the movie moves. It's got ebbs and flows. The love interest is awesome. The overcoming the deal with the parents being not wanting them to be together is awesome. Like, oh. It's so good, but if you're going to be like, well, it wasn't actually karate, so we should be tight. We get it. And they say it's kung fu in the movie. Jackie Chan's not going to let that slide, but it's called Karate Kid because it's a notable franchise, and they're remaking the movie The Karate Kid.
Yeah.
It hurt. But anyway, sorry, go ahead.
And also, so Jaden Smith was in that.
Yes, and he did a great job.
Has he done any other movies?
Since that? Yeah, I think so.
Or like in general, it's not I can't remember off the top of my head except for the Karate Kid of like, oh, Jaden Smith is in this movie.
He did that one with his dad where they were like going to different planets.
Pursuit of Happiness?
No. So this one, Jaden was older, and I think they're like going to different planets and something like that. I remember it was not good. I did not enjoy it.
Devil's River off Highway 163 in Southwest Texas. Cedar Canyon,
you see this in the chat? There was three. There were four Three Ninja movies. There were four.
Really?
Wow. Okay, we
love the first one.
We should watch this. We should watch all three of them.
I literally lived and died by the first one. I thought it was the coolest thing in the world. Rocky Loves Emily. Come on, dude.
Oh jeez. When he had the Game Gear telling the future.
Dude. The first Three Ninjas was so badass, dude.
Yeah.
It was such a good movie.
Did you ever watch Surf Ninjas?
Never even heard of it.
Are you kidding me?
What is Surf Ninjas?
Bro, Surf Ninjas is wild. So first off, Rob Schneider is in it.
Oh, already awesome.
Leslie Nielsen is the bad guy.
Oh, even better.
And he's on a... on like a deserted island is his evil base. Oh jeez. Leatherface is already on us.
I love that Leslie Nielsen is the bad guy.
Yeah, I can't believe you've never even heard of it.
Never even heard of it. Whoa. Someone's already down and out.
Where are you? Are you near? I'm like right next to his lair. Him being Leatherface.
I'm not sure.
Oh, I see him. She's chasing somebody. Chasing somebody. Okay. Can someone get a synopsis for Surf Ninjas, please? Because I do not remember anything besides them. Oh no. Ernie Reyes Jr. is in it. Karate guy. Big karate guy. Oh no. Oh no, I'm dead. I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die. Don't die. I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die. Oh, his.
Don't die.
His deal ran out. You stupid. Not stupid. Don't kill me. Don't kill me. Please no. Please no. Pour that health on you, baby girl. You're not stupid. I'm sorry. That was rude. Ernie Reyes Jr. was in it. Yeah, so, Ernie Reyes Jr. was Kino in Turtles.
Dude, who's Kino?
The pizza guy.
Ah, the pizza guy.
Yeah.
So, actually, the pizza guy was also, I think he played some of the Turtles.
He did?
I remember looking it up. And he's like a crazy martial artist. And he played, I swear he played like one of the Turtles as well, or some of the scenes with the Turtles.
You know what other movie he's in?
What?
He's in The Rundown, and he fights The Rock in the jungle.
That's right! You're right! Oh, I'm getting smoked. I'm getting smoked here.
Oh, no. Run. I have a shank if you need it.
Dude, I'm running. I'm crawling back in the well. Hopefully I make it.
Oh, you got upstairs already?
Yeah.
Dude, you're so good at these types of games. Oh, no. They saw me.
Fell in the well.
Oh, no. Okay, sir.
I'm hurting.
Here, Surf Ninja follows two teenage surfers from Los Angeles who discover that they are crown princes of... Oh, jeez! Oh, no! Oh, that scared the crap out of me. Ah, oh, my face! Don't touch me! Oh, I'm sweating.
Oh, finally.
I don't care.
I need to find the others.
Oh, I should have used that health. Uh-oh. I completely lost that health. That's me not paying attention. And now they're looking at me. I'm just running. Yo! Yo! I'm so tired!
Are you getting slaughtered?
Yeah, I am. I'm talking about these movies, dude. I'm talking about these movies. Leatherface, when you hear that chainsaw, dude.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I see you. I see you. Is he gonna get you? Oh, somebody's in the freezer. Okay, sorry. Surf Ninjas follows two teenage surfers from Los Angeles who discover they are crown princes of an Asian kingdom, Patusan, and reluctantly follow their destinies to dethrone an evil colonel. I already know one thing that you would like immediately about the movie. So they're going to school in a Jeep, right?
Oh, yeah.
Top down. And they pull out oars and they act like they're surfing, like they're rowing the Jeep to school.
Love it. Love it.
Oh, he's close. Oh, brother's getting hacked up. Brother's getting hacked up. He's done. Naruto Tails is done. No, he's gonna shoot. Don't stand alive. BG style. Can Naruto Tails? Naruto Nine Tails.
Is there two on him?
Oh no! Oh no! Oh, there's three on him! Bro, they're all downstairs. There's three on him. Oh no! You are screwed, dude. They're all downstairs.
I'm the last victim. I'm the last victim.
You. It's just you. Oh, come on. What you got? Hey, it's time to show the world, dude.
Oh, this ain't happening.
Nope, now they see you. Now they see you.
They know I'm right there.
Do you see them all?
I saw them. They had to have seen me.
Oh, bro. This Leatherface is nasty.
At this point, I got the best defense is good offense.
Come on, you got this. After this, we're watching the trailer for Surf Ninjas and Three Ninjas. And maybe the next Karate Kid. said, I'm a manager at a movie theater. We could make gaming on the big screen totally a thing. Gaming would be great, but also would be great. It's 80 movies. What are you doing running like that? They're about to bust you. Why did they fall so hard? You gotta find. Oh, nope, you're done.
Come on, man. You didn't even stab him. Leatherbeast, how do you get there so fast?
They were waiting on you.
Just like Grandpa taught me.
Dang. Just like Grandpa taught me.
Full slaughter on that one.
Dang.
Rough for the victims.
Bro, when they jumped down that well, why did he just take a flat back?
He's hurting.
You think he was training at your school?
Maybe. He was also getting hacked in half at the top of the well.
Dude, 3 Leatherface kills.
Yeah, he was nasty on that one.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that. You know who else is in Surf Ninjas?
Who?
Tone Loke.
Really?
Yes. Is he a cop? Oh, okay. Decon, yes. Okay.
Wait, there's a Double Dragon movie?
You've never seen it?
I don't think so.
Breeze, stop the presses. Hold on. Hey, guys, we're allowed to watch movie trailers on this. Yeah, because we do the thing with like Sonic and stuff.
Are we?
Yeah. Yeah, we've done trailers before. This is going to blow your mind. Because you...
We need 2 more people in here, by the way. The code on this one is ZR2MT3. Dub drag, dude.
Bro, I cannot... Dude, the full movie is on YouTube. It's 1 hour and 35 minutes. How much longer is the stream?
Is it...
Bro, I'm... So be careful with the music.
Yeah, music is always what gets you.
It's the HD trailer. Here we go. Okay. All right. Breeze, can I? If I share my screen with you, it's gonna mess up.
Oh, hold on. I can watch the stream.
No, because I need you to react to it. Like, well, you'll be like what, 10 seconds behind?
Something like that.
Okay. So I need to, so that you can hear this, I need to 1 second. Add that. Double Dragon. Create new. Boom. Okay. I'm going to turn down the game.
Okay.
Game audio off. You're on the stream?
I'm watching the stream.
Okay. Boom. Here we go. It might be really loud at first. It's very loud. Dude. Oh, wait. I'm not showing the stream. I'm just watching it myself. I'm over here so excited, and it's not
just
even
enjoying
on.
Enjoying yourself as we're waiting.
It's not even on.
Okay.
All right, let me fix this. Oh, geez. Okay. Let's see. Which window? Nope, not chat. Boom. Properties. Here we go. Double Dragon. Bam.
Come on.
Okay. I'm like Louis Leona. Okay. You can see it?
Platinum Daytona. Not yet.
Okay. It's coming up.
Not yet.
I'm so excited.
I'll let you know when it pops up.
I'll start this over. Yeah, you're going to be a little behind.
Dub drag, dude.
You know what? I'm gonna share my screen with you. Okay, I'm gonna share my screen with you.
Okay.
Okay.
Louis Leona. Platinum Daytona.
Boom. Boom. Now this is all messed up.
That's fine.
I can turn that off, right? For me. Don't focus. Get it out of here. Get it out of here. Okay, fine. We'll just watch the stream and talk. Okay, guys, you can hear us. Everybody can hear us. We're all good. We're doing it. Here we go. Double Dragon trailer. Well, I feel like we have to be on. That's going to be a little much. All right. I'm doing it. Here we go. This is working. Entertain the people for a second, Breeze.
There we go. There we go. Oh, Alyssa Milano's in it. People are saying.
Yeah. Look, my hair looks crazy right now. Oh, this is a green screen. We're doing it quick. Quick adjustment so we can watch this.
Also, Eric McGowan, Chris Conrad from The Next Karate Kid was Johnny Cage in Mortal Kombat.
Boom.
Oh. So The Next Karate Kid was the Hilary Swank one?
Yes.
And one of the guys in it was Johnny Cage from Mortal Kombat. Chris Conrad, Eric McGowan.
The love interest. Holy crap, I didn't even realize that.
That was Johnny Cage?
Yeah. I thought he looked familiar.
Flip through.
Okay. Okay. That's cool. Okay, here we go. Boom. Double Dragon coming in.
Double Dragon.
You hear it? So sick.
Also, one of those bad guys just looked like Doc. Pretty sure that main bad guy is the liquid metal guy.
So good.
Dude, this looks nuts.
It's amazing.
Also, the two guys who play the brothers are very familiar as well.
Yeah.
It is Robert. So that is Robert Patrick from Terminator 2.
Oh, it is? Okay.
Hell yeah. Yeah. Liquid metal, dude.
Dude, that's so sick. Okay, I'm going to flip these back.
That okay. Stop I need sharing. To watch that.
Flip this back.
I need to watch that for sure.
It's incredible. I haven't thought about that movie in a long time. But that is definitely something that we need to watch.
What? Magnus is saying the movie is so bad.
Bro, get out of here, dude.
Come on, man. Get Come out on, of. Dude.
That's like saying the Super Mario movies with John Leguizamo was bad.
Also The Pest with John Leguizamo.
The Pest? Come on.
Have you never seen it?
No, I've seen it.
And what about it?
I love The Pest.
Okay, good. The Pest is the best. I love it.
The Pest? It's not John Leguizamo, but Hot Chick, Rob Schneider.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Great. What was the other one that he did? The Animal?
Yeah, The Animal.
The Animal? Great.
There's another one. Benchwarmers.
He said one of the brothers is the Iron Chef guy, and the other was in the Street Fighter movie.
Do you mean the Iron Chef guy that bites the pepper?
Well, I gotta look this up. I gotta look this up because those guys look very familiar.
Yeah, we need a Deuce Bigalow. That's a huge.
So I love Deuce Bigalow. I thought Deuce Bigalow was so good.
Great movie. Also, John Leguizamo, Mario Brothers with John Leguizamo was so bad. Chris Silva, I don't understand what you mean. That was the first time. So when they got arrested in that movie and they go, name first and last, Mario goes, Mario, Mario. And then Luigi goes, Luigi, Mario. And I was like, oh, that makes perfect sense. I just thought Mario was the front man, so it's called the Mario Brothers. No, that's their last name.
Yeah. So the dude, one of the dudes in Double Dragon was in John Wick 3. And then he was also in Cradle to the Grave. John Wick 1. Kickboxer 5.
Kickboxer 5. Yeah, he's in a lot of stuff.
Which also, I just did a Kickboxer marathon. They're awesome.
What's marathon?
I watched them all. Like, I watched all the kickboxers.
Oh, yeah.
Back to back.
Yeah.
So, this guy's actually been in a lot of stuff. And then, what are the others? Scott Wolf. I know that name sounds familiar.
Yeah.
But I know he's been in stuff. Party of Five.
Yeah, okay.
That was a big show. That was a big show.
Yeah.
Exception, Saved by the Bell. NCIS. He's been in lots of stuff.
Yeah, we saw Rob Schneider is in Surf Ninjas. I would throw on another trailer, but I feel like then we're just doing a whole different stream. So we need to play play this game.
we get distracted easily. Here.
Yes. We should, though. We should watch movies, because I really enjoyed watching all five Karate Kids. And I feel like if you and I watched like a trilogy of movies and then just sat down and talked about them for like an hour.
Oh, yeah. We would have differing takes on almost everything.
Oh, every single thing.
Every movie. Also, I literally just finished watching it. The Equalizer 3.
Was it good?
Denzel. Very good.
Okay. I like the first two.
Have you seen 1 and 2?
Yeah.
You should watch 3. You'd like it.
Bro, anytime he starts looking at his clock or his watch, I'm like, oh, it's about to go down.
Dude, there's a couple scenes in there where he's just so like, he's not even trying. He's just like this like badass dude. It's great. It's great. But Equalizer 3, great movie.
That... Him looking at his watch and telling him how long it's going to take reminded me of, remember Sherlock Holmes?
Yeah.
With Robert Downey Jr.
Robert Downey? Oh, yeah, great.
When he would go through the fight in his head and then it'd come out the same way. It's like, oh, this is so good.
Dude, those Sherlock Holmes movies were really good, by
the way. They're great.
Really, really good.
Okay. Are we ready?
I need one more in here.
Okay.
ZR2.
MT3. ZR2 TM3. Or you know what? Okay, so I was gonna do this because I think Jackie Chan's been in like 297 movies or something like that.
He's been a lot. Which also, by the way, what is the Shanghai Noon?
Yeah. Him and Owen Wilson.
Yeah, and then there's another one, Shanghai Nights.
Yep.
Both very good.
Yeah. Great movies.
Great movies.
His movie with Cena is on Netflix right now. What is it called?
Who, Jackie Chan?
Yeah. Massively underrated movie, like the Equalizer movies. The Foreigner with Jackie Chan. Very good movie. Very good.
I don't know if I've seen that.
So I'm only missing like 8 or 12 Jackie Chan movies. I have all the other ones.
Like owning them.
I own them. Yeah, they're over on my bookshelf right now with all my games.
Wow.
I think Jackie Chan is the greatest talent to ever be in front of a camera. He's
very good.
Incredible. So what I was going to do is watch all of his movies in order when they were released.
That's cool. The chronological Jackie Chan career?
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah.
You get to watch all the Rush Hours?
Oh, yeah. I like how you're in the Rush Hours.
Rush Hours great.
They are great. Are we going Family or Victims?
I'm Family right now.
Okay.
And you're also.
Somebody's name is Shrek on crack.
Anyone can join here, guys, by the way.
Yeah.
We can join. If you've played already, feel free to join.
Have you seen any of Jackie Chan's movies that aren't made in America?
Yeah, at least a couple.
Okay, like Project A? Or like Police Story or Wheels on Meals?
I feel like Police Story and Meals on Wheels.
Wheels on Meals.
Wheels on Meals.
Wheels on Meals.
What? Meals on Wheels.
No, it's Wheels on Meals.
Is it?
Yeah, it's Wheels on Meals. Yeah.
Sounds backwards.
I know.
Yeah. Oh, sorry. The code on this one. U6YP8V.
U6YP8V.
V.
Jackie Chan cartoon is great. Said we have to address the show WMAC Masters. You didn't have that show in Canada, did you?
Not that I know of. If you did, I never watched it.
Have you heard of it?
Yeah, I think so. I think you've shown me it.
Okay, yeah. That's a show that needs to come back.
Chris asking, what is Jackie Chan's first movie ever?
I want to say it was some Bruce Lee movie. Because he was a stunt man in Enter the Dragon, I think. That may not have been his first, though.
Wait, Jackie Chan was in Enter the Dragon?
Yeah.
No way.
So
that's
so,
literally in my queue right now to watch again.
So, but he was a stunt man, and he may have been in some of the scenes in the back, I think. I got to go back and check.
That's cool. I didn't know that.
So one of his big ways that he got seen is, so he did a stunt. I want to say it was in Enter the Dragon. I got to go back and check. He did a crazy stunt, and Bruce Lee...
Drunken Fist. So good, dude.
Yes. Yes. Bruce Lee was super impressed with him, and one thing led to another, and then he was supposed to be, like, the next Bruce Lee, right? They made Fist of Fury?
Yeah.
I think, and then that was, like, the number one selling movie for a long time, and then they were like, okay, cool, he's our next action star. Then he tried to come to the States, but it didn't work out well, like consumer-wise. And then he started making, like, putting a little bit of comedy into stuff, because it was like, Superman is Superman. Like, he's like, no one's going to be Bruce Lee.
Yes.
Like, but I can do all this stuff, and I can put comedy to it, and no one's doing that.
That's true, yes.
And then his stuff just took over. So
he was very good with that.
Yeah, just getting punched in the face and going, like, ah, my nose, and then getting right back in the fight, like... I'll talk about Jackie Chan movies literally all day.
So Bruce Lee was big in bringing martial arts movies to the States, and then Jackie Chan took it in a whole different direction.
Yeah.
Because again, I like that. It's like, you're not going to outdo Bruce Lee when it comes to martial arts.
No.
What else can you add to it?
Yeah.
And he added like really good stuff.
Yeah. That's okay. So to be real, that's why I wanted to start New Day with Kofi and E and go the route that we did. Because...
Jackie.
Because everyone was already doing something, and it's like, well, I could try to do the same thing with somebody else and try to, like, work and hone my craft and, like, make it do their thing better, but it's like, why try to do their thing when I can do a different thing and just be the best at that and be as just as popular? It's like, oh, that's... That makes sense. Let me try the Jackie Chan way.
That's smart. I get that.
Who's your Hollywood person?
Like, what do you mean?
Like, Jackie Chan is like my idol, and I watch all of his movies. Like, do you have a person in Hollywood who's like your guy? Or girl?
That's tough, man. Because I think I have a couple. Ooh, I found somebody.
Ooh, Donde. Who are you
get
playing
back
as?
Here. Sissy.
Okay, so I'm not gonna follow that guy. They're upstairs?
Yep, they're by Grandpa.
Already? Jeez.
They just jumped out the window.
Okay, good. I'm staying down here because there's gotta be at least one other person down here.
Moving quick. Yeah, it depends. I don't know if I have one person. I mean, I've always loved, like, Adam Sandler.
Oh, great.
But then, like, that's always an offshoot of, like, I like Rob Schneider.
Yeah.
And I like Kevin James.
You like the crew of Friends.
Basically, yeah.
But there's
a lot to it. There's a lot to it. Ooh, I see somebody.
Where are they?
Running out.
Outside?
They're running out by, like, the, the path.
Okay. I'm outside now, too.
They're out by the path.
Escaped already?
They must already turn off the generator.
Good
and gone that way.
Lord.
Go turn
all right.
The back on.
Basement exit is open too. I'm going back downstairs.
Oh my god, they are going crazy here.
Okay. Okay,
oh
you guys
god.
Gotta calm down. Bro, start this one over.
What is happening?
Run it back real quick. And we weren't paying attention. That's not fair. All right, where's that basement door?
I don't know. I'm keeping an eye open here for anyone who's running.
Oh, I just let her run past me. She was running behind me the whole time. And she ran out. And she's out. And she's a good lord. Just trash.
I'm the final victim, dude.
Well, now I'm standing by the door. We'll see.
I'm outside.
Door's about to close. Good. Door's closed. Perfect. You think they're upstairs or downstairs? Bro, they just made a fool of us. They're making a fool of us.
I'm turning. Okay, I got that electrified again.
Closing this door. Turn the light on. It's dark.
God,
in here.
We didn't even feed Grandpa when they're out of here.
No. Okay, I'm opening the door again. This is rough. He said trolling me is pretty funny if you just run behind him the whole match. Ha ha ha.
Whoa.
Ha ha ha. What?
Oh, come
and they're
on,
out.
Man. What a clean. That was fast, dude.
And they're out.
That was very fast. How did you kill so quickly?
You know what? I know what the problem is.
What's the problem?
Blood sugar's low. I need an Oreo.
That must be it. No other explanation.
Mm-hmm.
3RU PvP.
Leon. Le2 Demis says, we all know anyone with an afro is Breeze's Hollywood person. He said it in a previous episode.
Who is it?
Anyone with an afro.
I mean, they're not wrong. Also, I'm trying to think of like 90s movies. Like Martin Lawrence, I watched all of Martin Lawrence stuff.
It's great movies.
But love Will Smith.
Mm-hmm.
Love Denzel.
We just got obliterated.
That was nasty.
We got equalized, dude.
We got equalized. Oh, you know what's a great movie? Training Day.
Oh, of course.
Denzel, Ethan Hunt. Mm.
Give me that damn sentence.
King Kong ain't got nothing on me. I love it.
Oh, yes. Great overlooked action flicks. Universal Soldier with, is that Mario Van Peebles?
One of the Universal Soldiers had Goldberg in it, I think.
What?
Yeah, because I remember because he had yellow glasses on.
No way.
I'm telling you. Also, Tony Jaa was huge. Like, Ong Bak came out, and he had like one or two others, and then he kind of fell off the face of the earth. Does he still make movies?
I don't know.
Go back and watch Ong Bak. So, like, crazy, crazy martial arts sequences. He's also in The Raid. I think he's in The Raid.
No.
He's not The Raid?
No, he's not in The Raid. That's a different group of guys. There was another one
that's very close after Ong Bak, but it's not.
It's the one about where he's the protector.
The protector, that's the one.
Where he's got
the
elephant.
That's the one I'm thinking of.
They do that stunt where they're running through the city, and he does an aerial between those two panes of glass.
Yes.
So I watched I'm a weirdo. I watched them talking about training to do that whole like chase sequence.
Yeah.
And they set up a fake city of like styrofoam or something or foam, something like that. And they ran it for months.
Really?
Yeah. Because they just kept, I want to say
they wanted one take, right?
Yeah. Something weird like that.
They wanted one take. They love the one take. I think that's why I thought Raid was one of theirs.
No, so that's a different group of guys. That guy, I thought he was Tony Jaa, but that's a different guy. I can't remember his name.
Also very good.
That's
code for this one, 42RT7Z.
Boom. I thought it was Tony Jaa for a while. But when I saw that, I was like, that's the best action movie I think I've ever seen in my life.
Which one?
The Raid.
Insane.
Yeah. But
again, that one is also added to my queue to watch because it's just so cool.
Wait, you haven't seen it?
I've seen it.
Oh, you can watch it again.
I want to watch it again, yeah. I went through like a martial arts, like just rabbit hole and started queuing up everything. So mm-hmm. I did a kickboxer marathon. I got Bloodsport on there. I went through all the Rambos.
Mm-hmm.
Just a big mix.
Did you watch The Raid 2?
I don't think so.
Watch the second one.
Worth watching?
Oh, of course. I think I'm biased to the first one, but the second one is unreal. And I think so. The Raid was top action movie for me just because it was so gross. But then that same group of guys made a movie called The Night Comes for Us.
Yeah.
That has the gnarliest fight scenes I've ever seen.
What is it called?
The Night Comes for Us.
And those are the same guys that were in The Raid.
Yes. It's a whole stunt troupe. The only thing that turns me off to it a little bit is there's a lull in the middle and the movie's mad long.
Oh yeah. Damn, I can't even find it on here.
It's on Netflix.
Maybe that might have to be right now.
But it's so good. I just wish the middle part was shorter. What is it? Truncated. I wish it was truncated. But the Night Comes for Us next to The Raid, I think The Night Comes for Us is better, because wow. It's.
I think you also need to go back and watch Ong Bak, because.
Okay.
Really, really underrated. I remember when it came out, I saw a couple of them and I went, whoa, this is like, when you think that martial arts movies can't go to the next level, they took it to the next level.
Yeah.
And it's like, dude, it was so cool because he's elbowing and kneeing and stuff. It was so much more than just a typical karate or kung fu movie.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. I remember it took it to another level. It was like what when I thought comedy maxed out, and then all of a sudden Superbad came out, and then I went to another level.
You know what I mean? When he said, what was his name? Something Muhammad?
McLovin.
McLovin. But what was the first name?
Oh, he was going to go Muhammad.
Muhammad McLovin.
Muhammad? He goes, what are you doing? And then his first one that he did was Muhammad something. And then he said, that's stupid. So he got another one. And it was just McLovin. His name was just McLovin. Go back and watch that. It's a great movie.
It's the most common name on the planet. Read a book.
Yeah, dude. Superbad. Such a good movie, dude.
Is this you next to me?
Spinning circles?
Yeah. I'm Thickums right now.
There you go. Thickums.
I mean,
you better run, son.
Why?
I hear chainsaw.
Well, I don't. Oh, jeez. Yeah. Oh, no.
You dummy.
Go. You just ran back in. You just ran back in. What are you doing?
Did I run back into the same one?
Yes.
Oh, my goodness.
Hey, thanks for taking the heat.
I literally just did a circle to get chopped down.
Oh, no. Whoops.
Oh, making, God, he found me.
I'm just making noise for no reason.
I did two circles and he caught me. Danny has passed.
Oh, wait, he got you? Oh, no.
He got me.
Oh, no.
All right, I'm watching you, buddy.
Somebody, okay.
You're hurting. You need some help.
I hear him. Oh, we gotta watch Tropic Thunder too.
Great movie.
Tools though. Oh geez. Let me find some tools, dude. Oh great. They're escaping and I am not. Okay.
You gotta move, bud.
I'm too thick to move quick. Oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no.
you, bud.
I can't yet. Grandpa. Okay.
I like how I literally said, hey, man, I think I hear a chainsaw. You're like, I don't. A second later, we're getting hacked to bits.
Julia, please, let's stay together.
There you go.
Yeah, come on.
Better tail that.
Oh, no.
Uh-oh. We're moving.
No! Come on!
Smoked by like three of them. You better get out of here.
I'm good. Just stay calm.
Kung Pao into the fist? No, I've never seen that.
Oh, you gotta watch Kung Pao.
Isn't that like a comedy?
Yeah. Why won't they leave me alone? I wonder if they open that door. Kung Pao is pretty funny. It's been a minute.
I feel like I remember the previews for it. You know what the movie that I've probably seen the preview to the most and I've never seen it?
What?
Major Pain.
You've never seen Major Pain?
I've never seen it. It was always just on the preview before Billy Madison on the VHS.
What's that
I had. I remember it, I'm pretty sure it was Major Pain and Joanna Man.
You're fine without seeing Joanna Man.
I owned it. I bought it and it was in like a dollar bin and I was passing by and I was like, I'm buying this.
Come on.
He's just standing there waiting for me.
Dang it. I got upstairs though.
Literally right on your heels. Right on your heels, hacking into bits.
Oh yeah, Bam Bam Bigelow's in Major Pain.
Is he really?
Yeah. Damn, I got rocked. Okay, here we go. Come on, Viper. Viper.
Is he the last one? Lone one standing.
Viper's last person standing.
Come on, Vipes, dude. Do us proud here.
Yeah, Major Pain is unreal. It's a very you movie too.
So I found I'm very Williams Brothers. I love everything they do. They're so funny. The early, I don't know, I'd have to go back and watch like the later scary movies. The early scary movies are masterpieces. Mm-hmm. They are so good. Also, I'm pretty sure. No, I don't think they were in Joanna Man.
Thank you, Lord.
No.
Joanna Man, very good.
Yeah. So you've probably never seen Blank Man.
We've had this conversation. I've never seen Blank Man.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure I brought a Joanna Man and you brought a Blank Man. Oh, thanks.
This is rough. The families have been on.
Families have been very good.
Not when we're the family, but the families have been good otherwise.
Yeah. The victims were very good in the last one. Now the family is very good. Basically, whatever we're not, they're very good.
I feel like, So obviously we got Brands coming up on Thursday.
Yep.
We got to get together and film for next week.
Code, by the way, M3QZML. Or WL, sorry. M3QZWL.
But what we need to do is you need to watch Major Pain. I know, I'll watch it with you.
We need to watch along, dude.
We could do that. But so there's like a couple movies you need to watch. So you need to watch Major Pain because that's a very you movie. Just for not, so you need to watch Blank Man because you will probably pee your pants laughing at Blank Man.
What's a movie that you've never seen? Like a surprising movie that you haven't seen.
I still haven't seen Creed 3.
You've never seen Creed 3?
I still haven't seen Creed 3.
That's kind of surprising.
Yeah.
Loved Creed 1 and 2, obviously.
Oh,
so
yeah.
So why haven't you watched Creed 3?
I don't know the reason.
Just haven't gotten around to it.
yeah, but I really want to. And everybody that's seen it said I'll like it so much because it's very anime in the last fight. But I don't know. I was gonna actually watch it today.
But you didn't.
No, did not. Ended up going to get a foot massage.
Oh, how's that?
Incredible. Sorry, Decon has put a great movie.
Yes, Decon, I've seen it. That's a classic one. That's a classic one.
Oh, man. What's the code?
Sorry, I'm creating a lobby now.
Okay. Harlem Knights, yeah.
Code is U6YP9V. Are you going, you're going family?
I'll go victim. Let me get Anna.
There you go. There you go.
Something that's weird that I haven't seen. No, I did see Tenet. Tenet's incredible.
It's gotta be something you've never seen. Did you? I never watched it.
I did. You should watch it. You'd like it.
I will.
Why?
I just won't. Now it's one of those things that's like up on a pedestal.
It's really good.
I won't do it.
Okay. All right. I don't know. Nate, you got to name something.
I haven't seen Saltburn. I just added it to the list.
What's Saltburn?
I heard it was a new movie. Okay. I heard it was pretty good, but I haven't seen it yet, so I can't comment on it.
Mm-hmm.
What is a lot of people are mentioning Meteor Man.
Meteor Man is great. So you'll watch Meteor Man and Blank Man like back to back.
Oh. Meteor Man is it a sequel?
No. Completely separate movies. It's a guy, Robert Townsend. It's great. But there was like a I can't even tell you what the plot was. I just remember one specific thing about it that was had me crying laughing at the time. But I don't want to ruin it because it's pretty funny. It's black superheroes. It's like there's genre.
I kind of like. So I guess. It's funny to me because like you know obviously, I enjoy the black community and the culture very much.
Yes.
But it's always I get so surprised because I just don't know these things. So yeah. Like, I never know that there's like the black version of. Whatever, so like,
yeah,
the Wizard of Oz and the Wiz,
yeah.
Or like, whatever you just said, Blank Man is like, you know, essentially whatever. I don't know what other version it would be, or yeah, Meteor yeah. Man,
or like, so like Living Single. They took that idea and they made Friends.
Yes.
So what friend? Yeah. Anyway, go ahead.
So, but there's always like these different versions that I never knew existed. But it's funny because there's always like mm-hmm. it's like a. They're like the same.
Yeah.
Dude, the same but different.
They're so good. They're so good.
What are
good.
Some more? I know there's more
yes,
out there.
Brian.
I know there's more out there.
Did you ever watch The Phantom? Is it The Phantom? What's the guy's name? Is it Billy Zane? Is that what his name is? Do you remember so it's very specific. Do you remember in Zoolander when they're about to do the walk-off and the one guy goes up to him and he's like, are you sure you want to do this?
Yes.
That guy is in a movie called The Phantom, I think it's called, where he's just like in a purple leotard and he rides a white horse.
Okay.
Horrified today. You ever seen that or heard of that?
No, I don't think so. From one of the
homes in the neighborhood. Tell me in the chat, guys, if it's called The Phantom. Okay, it is Billy Zane. Frog legs, the horse hooves, the human eyeball. What was The Phantom about? I remember watching that and liking it. People keep saying The Crow. You've seen The Crow, yeah?
Seen The Crow.
Okay. What else are people putting in there? Dark Man.
Never seen Dark Man.
Is Dark Man the one where he's invisible and he's wrapped up? Or is that the Invisible Man?
Stay calm, Lana. There's gotta be something I can use around here.
Crap, oh crap.
You hear him. I hear him.
He's around.
I hear him.
Where are you? I feel like you're in front of me.
I'm like in a room. I don't know. I'm in the west cell.
Okay, I'm in the north tunnel.
Okay. I see, I saw some tools a second ago.
Oh god, he's coming, he's coming.
Not for me. You're damn right, John Leguizamo was good in Romeo and Juliet.
He's good in everything.
His Capulet guns. I bite my tongue at thee, or whatever, bite my thumb at thee. Darkman is Liam Neeson.
Okay. Oh, I love Liam Neeson.
Looks like some kind of lockpick. Somebody's already out of the basement.
Thank God.
Good. Don't move.
Crap.
Oh, he's chasing me. That's not good.
Oh, no, 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 no.
That sucks, dude.
I should have got there. Oh god, he's so fast. He's so fast. Oh no! How did he know? That sucks.
I'm unlocking a door quickly, quietly. Okay.
His lead face is all over.
Okay. I'm opening a door.
I'm hurting. I'm about to bleed out. Recover, dude. I guess just passed out on the floor. Get up, you dummy.
Uh-oh. Please don't.
Don't worry.
Please don't touch me.
I'll find you.
I'm hidden. Oh, please run by me. Please run by me. Thank you. No, he didn't see me. Let's go.
That's it, Alma. Stay hidden.
Jeez. Oh. They didn't see. Okay. We're doing okay. We're doing okay, dude.
You're out of health. I'm out of health.
You're out? I don't have health. I got another unlock tool.
I'm about to get out of the basement.
All right.
Maybe I'm not. Oh, there's a ladder. I'm out of the basement.
Okay.
I'm out of the basement.
Good. Okay. Is somebody chasing you?
Nope.
Okay.
Not yet, anyway.
Okay.
I wonder where this goes.
We're okay. Oh, jeez! Okay. Oh jeez! Oh no, they're about to tear me to pieces. Oh no. No. Get out of here, dude. Okay, come on. There's another trap, dude. I'm done. Whatever, dude. Recovered. Nope, and I'm done.
I thought I just saw you, and I saw something else.
I'm done, dude.
Yeah, I'm very close because I can hear him getting slaughtered.
I gotta eat another Oreo, dude.
Just like Grandpa taught me.
Dang it.
Gotcha. Ooh.
Ooh. Somebody escaped. Somebody's back in the hole.
Slow down.
Okay, come on, Breeze.
Attention.
Come on, Breeze.
Damn, the pressure valve. I never know where the valve is. No!
Oh, Black Dynamite. Great movie. Oh, nope.
It's no time to pick the lock, dude. Oh,
no, you're passed out. You're out of.
I'm so dead.
You're out of blood.
He hacked me. Just watching you go down.
Watching you bleed out.
Come on, man.
Oh, this is rough. Pootie Tang, incredible movie.
Pootie Tang.
Pootie Tang. Sunny tide on a wetty tide.
Pootie Tang. Right.
Yeah.
Like Tales that. From, well, yeah, didn't you say, so Tales from the Crypt?
Yeah, Tales from the Hood.
Tales from the Hood, yeah. Yeah.
Great movie.
So funny.
Black Dynamite, absolutely incredible movie. Starship Troopers, did you see that movie? You know Starship Troopers.
Yeah. Yep.
Okay, one more Oreo.
You always thought Tales from the Hood was related to Tales of the Crypt, but I thought it was. I thought the same Crypt Keeper's in it. Is he not?
I think so, yeah. Okay, come on, Voodoo Child. Julie, you got this.
Voodoo Child, slow and stealthy here.
Underrated movie. Have you seen Daddy Daycare?
Yes.
So good.
Yep.
And Merry Christmas to you too. Happy New Year. Did you think of a movie that I maybe haven't seen?
That's what I'm trying to think of one. I gotta like look at like early 90s.
Yeah.
That's that, like, that category.
Yeah. Ooh, role movie, or role models. Role models, it's one of my favorite movies.
That was with Stifler at McLovin, right?
Yeah, it was.
I'm pretty sure.
It was.
And
he came in, he said, if you haven't seen it, they're going LARPing. He comes in with his sword and stuff. He goes, oh, what's your name? He said, Lunesta, because I send my opponents to their eternal resting place. It's like, That's good.
That's great. Did you see that they're remaking Mean Girls?
Yeah, I'm so pumped.
Are you?
Mean Girls is great.
I know, but they can't remake it.
Yeah, they can.
All right.
Why can't they remake it?
Because I feel like it's such a like niche that you just leave it alone.
Nah, you can update Mean Girls.
You can try.
It's probably gonna be so good. It's a musical too, isn't it?
I don't know.
I feel like I saw a preview where the kid hit the. She doesn't even go here. Like, I'll take that.
Probably. Ooh. How many of the Home Alones have you seen?
I want to say at some point all of them. But again, we saw that.
No
that,
way.
That's
no
one.
Way.
What do you mean, no way?
Are they gone?
There's no way you've seen all of them.
Why?
Are they really gone?
Because I think the later ones are really bad.
Like, how late are they, though? There's no, like, recent ones, right?
No, but I'm pretty sure there's, like, 6 or 7.
Oh, that's then definitely not. I know I've seen at least 3.
Yeah, well, there's 1 and 2, which are the classics.
Yeah.
Then there's 3 with the little kid.
Yeah.
And then after that, I'm pretty sure it changes every time.
No.
To someone else who's home alone that you don't care about.
So it's like Land Before Time, they just keep making them?
Yeah, but Land Before Time is still good, you know?
Yeah, that's
Wait,
true.
What do you mean they keep making them? Isn't there, like, 8?
There's how many Land Before Times are there, chat? Like 12? I feel like there's more than. I feel like there's at least.
And also, those are like, you know, illustrated dinosaurs.
Yeah, little foot.
To, yeah, Home Alone's different. Just leave it alone, you know?
I forgot about that movie, GLS. The what? Fan. You remember that movie with Wesley? He's getting stalked by a super fan.
I don't know if I've ever seen that.
Ooh. Oh no, Bear Trap.
Have you ever seen Half Baked?
Of course I've seen Half Baked. Great movie. When Chappelle tells him, he goes, because they're making so much money.
That was great.
Oh no. Oh wow, fell in the dirt. You know?
You're so good.
That's rough. When he tells them they have to start saving money, He goes, but you said you got your girlfriend a pearl necklace. He goes, you obviously didn't hear the point of that story. <It's>
like... So Chappelle was in like some sneaky, like early 90s funny movies.
Yeah.
Like Robin Hood, Men in Tights.
Mm-hmm. Best
and
line.
Have they, like
14 Land Before Time movies.
Come on.
That's too many, dude.
That's a lot.
I can't even get a White Chicks too.
No.
We got 14 Land Before Time movies. How many Air Bud movies are there?
Ooh, at least 5.
I'm gonna guess 7. Chappelle was in Con Air?
Was he?
What?
I feel like Chappelle's been in a lot of like stuff that you would not think that he'd be in.
Really?
You watch Hook?
Of course. I love Hook.
Just checking.
Yeah.
You know what I've never seen and Denzel Washington's in it?
What?
He Got Game.
It's been a long time since I've even heard of that movie.
Have you even seen it, though?
It's a long time ago. I don't remember anything about it.
Denzel spent the last 6 years in prison after accidentally killing his wife.
Oh.
He's a basketball player.
Jeez. Do you remember picking up the VHS tapes?
All the time.
Looking at the back, read that synopsis. Do I want to rent this one?
I loved going to the movie store and renting a movie.
Yeah.
I thought it was the coolest. And then even better, my mom had like a subscription to Columbia House,
mm-hmm.
where you get like a flyer and then a catalog, and you could like order VHS or CDs.
Yeah.
And so every like, you know, couple months you get to order something, and that's where I got Three Ninjas.
Oh, there it is. Oh,
and I also got a CD that was nothing but like 100 fart sounds. Great. The code for this one, V6RLZ9.
Wait, 7. So there's 12 Air Bud movies? What? Oh, after this game, we'll do the Cuban Pete. I don't know. I'll be honest. Anybody stand out? Who stood out? Because we've clearly been distracted.
Yeah, we've had some good people, but I have not watched any of them. Ooh, Rumble in the Bronx, great movie.
Incredible. Waterworld, not bad. Malibu's Most Wanted.
Men in Black movies, great movies.
Yeah. Bro, that... So I was living with my aunt in California when that first one came out, and the music video... Oh, did you put the code in?
I got one person in here, yep. We need one more at V6R. Oh, they're in.
Okay.
I'll set up the room and give you the other code.
I remember I was in California living with my aunt, and that music video came out for Men in Black.
Yep.
And I remember losing...
Here comes the Men in Black.
My mind. That song and the music video with the alien dancing. Let me see you just bouncing with me. Just bouncing with me. Come on. Let me see you just slide. Slide. Bro.
For this last one, are you going family or victim?
I'll go whichever. Who you want to go?
We'll stay victim.
Okay.
You already victim.
Let me get Anna.
And the code for this one, UWWNX6.
It's an underrated Will Smith movie, 7 Pounds. Is that the movie? So I've never seen
that. That's a rough one. That's a rough one.
Is that where he yells at the blind dude on the phone?
Maybe. I can't remember that part.
So, because there's a clip.
I just remember the overall movie, and it's awesome.
Okay. I just know that there's a clip where he calls in like a customer service guy, and I think the guy is blind, and he's super mean to him. But he's upset that he's got to be mean to him. So it's almost like he was forced by.
Yes.
Okay.
My guess is because he probably leaves his eyes to that guy.
Okay.
Because the 7 pounds is he ends up killing himself, and then.
Oh, don't tell me the movie. I'm just kidding.
Well, you gotta.
It's been long enough.
It's been years. But he ends up leaving like each body part to somebody who deserves it.
What?
So like he handpicks who it is. So it's probably that where he leaves that guy's eyes.
That's wild.
He's probably mean to him to see how he reacts to it, and the guy's nice, so he's like he deserves my eyes. That's my guess.
But he tears up his room after he's mean to him. He like says a bunch of mean stuff, hangs up, and then just rips his room apart because he was so mean to the guy. And
probably,
like, man.
Probably.
Oh, he was yelling at Woody Harrelson. It's rough.
I love Woody Harrelson.
He's great. You know, so this movie gets me, and it will always get me. Sorry, I'll write it. Interstellar.
Oh, great movie.
Bro, when he is yelling at his daughter when he's like floating through time inside the bookshelf.
Yeah.
That.
It's such a weird. That's such a like weird, you know, inception, like thinking of like, but wait, he was the one who made the noise and he was the one who knocked the thing off and then like, how is he there in a.
It's all a circle.
That always messes with me.
Time is a circle. We're doing it again and again and again.
Ooh, Zombieland, great movie.
Yeah. What is it? Step one, cardio.
Yeah. Rule one.
Rule one. When he kills, what's his name? Because he thinks he's a zombie. Bill Murray.
It hurts.
That's right.
I have to get out of here.
Okay, so all the tools are over there. Dope. Okay, here we go. Time to focus.
Focus
right, up.
Where are you?
I'm getting tools. I'm right next to Leatherface's lair.
Okay. I'm in the west tunnel.
Bro, north somebody's already out and upstairs. Yep. Bro, Voodoo Child is wild.
Yes. Voodoo Child's standing out a little bit.
Oof. F.
I shouldn't have moved.
I didn't.
You did the same thing?
Yep. Oh no.
Ooh, somebody got executed already.
Yep. Already. Okay. Nope.
I should see what that is.
Turn that light off. I think there's a door over here.
I'm at a door.
Okay.
Door's open.
What door?
You should see it. It pops up, doesn't
F.
it? Oh.
No, it doesn't.
Please let this stuff be safe.
Okay.
Oh God, they're close. Oh, I saw somebody moving down there. Was that you?
That was me.
I saw you on the far side.
That was me. It was for a second.
How'd they know I was there?
I think I saw where your door was.
Can I get through there?
Crap!
They're already getting you?
Yeah, he got me. Come he back. Somehow knew exactly where I was.
Come back downstairs, dude.
Oh, my body is, but I'm dead.
Oh, your body's downstairs?
It, literally on the stairs. I was running back down.
Oh, no.
I opened the door. I got out of there. They were literally right there.
Oh, no.
We're watching you.
Oh, no. Okay.
Voodoo Child is might be the Cuban Pete here.
Huh?
Voodoo Child might be the Cuban Pete.
Okay.
Standing out is very good.
Nope. Oh, F. Okay, we're okay. I need to find a door. I need to find the door because I put my tools down. I'm just rocking health.
There was a movie, it wasn't called Area 51. It was called Area Something. It was very good. It was about aliens.
Independence Day.
No, but great movie. Great movie. Hello, boys!
So good.
Ah, District. Okay. District.
District 9?
10? District 9? District 9. I'm pretty sure it was called District 9.
Yeah, District 9.
Have you seen Swordfish?
No.
Wow, great movie. John Travolta. Classic. And I'm pretty sure you get to see Halle Berry topless. Just as a side note.
Ew.
District 9, great movie.
Is that Ben...
John Travolta.
Oh. What's the movie Elysium? I think.
Elysium. I know I've seen it, and I think it was good. But I think Ben Affleck pulled that.
It's one of them. One of those guys.
Mars Attacks, never seen it.
Great movie.
Really?
Yeah, aliens with big old heads. Oh, jeez! Oh, no! Was I moving? I couldn't have been moving. I can't get in there. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Don't touch me. Don't touch me.
Oh, Hugh Jackman.
Don't touch me. Don't touch me. Don't touch
me. Yeah, Chappie. Do you ever see Chappie?
No.
Chappie was very good.
Rudy Tal got out.
Edge of Tomorrow, great movie. At least it was with Matt Damon.
There we go. That's who it was. That's the Matt.
Did you ever see Edge of Tomorrow?
Yeah, that's the one with Tom Cruise.
And we keep playing over and over?
Yeah, we talk about that one every time. It's a
great movie.
That's an incredible movie.
Great movie. Have you ever seen Braveheart?
Yes.
Have you ever seen Gladiator?
That's the
Russell
one.
Crow?
Beard guy? Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Beard guy. Russell Crowe, dude.
Beard guy.
Listen to this one. Ooh, Romeo Must Die. You ever seen it?
Yeah, of course. Of course. DMX? No, he doesn't. He doesn't have a beard and
black. That's Cradle to the Grave.
No, well, Romeo Must Die is Jet Li and DMX.
No, DMX is in Cradle to the Grave with Jet Li.
He's also in Romeo Must Die.
He's not.
He's not in Romeo Must Die?
No.
Who's in Romeo Must Die?
I'm
looking at his face in my head.
There's a couple people that I have no clue. In do you remember Me, Myself, and Irene?
Of course.
One of his sons is really funny. He's in a lot of stuff.
It's been a minute.
I have no clue what his name is, but he's hilarious in it. And Romeo Must Die, he is so good. He's very funny.
DMX is in Romeo Must Die, see?
Is he though?
They said, yeah, but it's only like a cameo.
Oh, I think he's the club owner.
Yeah, yeah.
Me, Myself, and Irene.
Who's the main bad guy in Romeo Must Die? Ooh, bear trap.
Anthony, do you know who Anthony Anderson is?
Yes.
So he's been in like everything.
Damn, yeah.
I always call him Maurice because I think in this, in there's a movie where I think he's Maurice in one of them.
Uh-huh.
But he's so funny, dude. In like his fight with Jet Li. He's like the ongoing bad guy who's like supposed to be the big tough guy.
Mm-hmm.
And he has all these fights with Jet Li where he just gets his butt kicked.
Oh, yeah.
But he keeps getting mad. But every time he sees him, he's like, oh, yeah, here we go. And then he gets his ass kicked. And Jet Li has these funny little like half English, you know, quips. Anthony Anderson, he's in
a bunch of stuff.
He's in lots of stuff. But in Romeo Must Die, the cast...
On Voodoo.
So DMX is Silk. That's right. That's right.
Silk.
Maurice. He's Maurice in Romeo Must Die.
He's Maurice.
Isaiah Washington.
Yes. Okay.
Isaiah Washington is one of the bad guys.
Yes.
Delroy Lindo is one of them as well.
Okay.
He's in lots of stuff. DB Woodside is another one.
Okay. It was Isaiah Washington that I've seen in my head. Dang.
These are all these dudes that, like, I've seen them in so much stuff, but I couldn't give you $1 million if you asked what their names were. Anthony Anderson has always, for the last 35 years, been Maurice. Oh, Maurice. He's so funny. He's great. He's in
Dang.
So much stuff.
Oh.
Scary Movie, Me, Myself, and Irene. Romeo Must Die. Ooh, Exit Wounds. Cool movie.
We gotta do movies.
Cradle to the Grave.
We gotta do movies.
Have you ever seen Malibu's Most Wanted?
Yes. It's been a long time. That's, what's the guy's name? Jamie Kennedy. Yeah. Dang, they tore us up. No, he is. It's the guy from Blackish. Yeah. That's Maurice.
He's literally been in everything. My God.
Yeah.
He's been in so much stuff. He's literally been in like everything from Urban Legends.
Oh, yeah.
He was in Urban Legends.
Yeah.
He was in
That's
Scream.
Great.
He was in Harold and Kumar Go to White Castle.
Great movie.
He was in Eddie and Martin Life.
Life. Good movie.
I don't know if I've ever seen that one.
Life is good. It's.
He was in a movie called Hoodwinked, animated movie. Great movie. It's about Little Red Riding Hood. It's great.
Okay.
He was in Scream 4. He was in, Big Mama's House. You remember Big Mama's House?
Yeah, I remember Big Mama's House.
What a great movie.
Yeah.
The Departed, great movie.
Mm-hmm.
Transformers, Hustle and Flow, Malibu's Most Wanted. He's literally like done the gambit of like what you could be in.
Here's a movie that I should have seen already that I haven't seen. What is the one? It's the one. It's like the British group of gentlemen or something like that.
Oh,
The Huntsman.
Kingsman.
Kingsman. Yeah.
Those are great movies.
I haven't seen the Kingsman movies, and I haven't seen any John Wick movies.
My goodness, you need to see, both of them. You need to see the Kingsmans, and you need to see the John Wicks.
Yeah.
Surprisingly, though, not a fan of the last John Wick.
Really?
Yeah. Loved the earlier ones. Didn't really like the last one.
I heard so many good things about all of them.
I know. Well, all of them, but the last one I didn't really like.
Yeah. We were,
I felt like it was a letdown.
Last time we flew, I guess we were flying international somewhere. I think maybe Australia. I don't know. Kofi watched all of them because he hadn't seen them.
Oh, right.
So he was just talking about
John
them.
John Wick's?
Yeah. Yeah. But I just haven't watched them. I know I need to watch them.
Ooh, have you ever seen Tenacious D, The Pick of Destiny?
Yes. Yes.
Great movie.
And you think it's time to rock and roll out of control? That?
Great movie.
His name is Kyle Gass. So question I'm going to pose to you and the chat, I guess. This was literally just us talking about movies.
Yes.
Like the whole time. I was not paying attention to look for any standouts for the Cuban Pete of the week.
Yep.
How do we do this?
Yes.
Do
we? I think we need to refer to the chat because they will know more than us.
Do you think that we select a Cuban Pete of the week? Chat, were there people that stood out that we should have in a game play against each other? Was there a moment that we missed that was maybe really good?
I don't even know if we can spectate.
Oh, yeah, that's fair. I did see League of Extraordinary Gentlemen. It is a great movie. But let me pause movies real quick and get this Cuban Pete business. Brian says...
Voodoo is good, yep.
Okay.
Voodoo, I did notice. I did notice
yeah.
Voodoo.
Solution is Kumite.
Saw movies, all very good. Just did a marathon of them. Very good.
It's a,
highly suggest it.
It's that all those people who clean swept you, which is a lot. It's like the whole chat.
Voodoo.
Yeah, I see lots
voodoo
of voodoo.
Voodoo is very good. A couple times. Voodoo was in there a couple times. Very good.
I see that Double Dragon trailer should be the Cuban Pete of the week. See,
Mystery Men.
So many good movies. Acoustic wants one more match. Can't forget stuff. Everybody's still in the movies.
That's right. Beverly Hills Ninja, great movie. Chris Farley.
Okay, so look, let's run one more. Then we'll all go to bed. Well, we don't all have to go to bed, but I'm gonna go to bed. Got stuff to do tomorrow. Did I ever ask Triple H about being in Blade? No. I haven't been back to work. I think I'll go. I gotta go to the doctor tomorrow to just get cleared for my wrist, and I'm good. So if I see him next week, I'll ask him. Because I really want to know what it was like.
Yep.
Hey, so you were on set with Wesley Snipes. Did you? And you saw him like in his Blade fit, like.
Yeah.
Do you have any pictures? Do you have any stories?
I wonder if he's cool with Wesley. Yeah. Also, Ryan Reynolds was in the one he was in.
Yes, and he was jacked out of his mind.
Jacked as hell.
Okay, let's run one more.
Shattermind was tearing it up too.
Okay, so if Shattermind is in here, get Shatter in here. If Voodoo's in here, get Voodoo in here. And then we'll, can you invite me?
I'm creating a party.
All right. Here we go.
The code for this one is 8UPVUY.
What is it, sorry?
Eight U P V U Y.
There we go. Ooh.
Yeah.
So Wesley wasn't in Blade 3. It was a stunt double who did most of the stunts. He hated doing that Blade. Why?
Wait, Wesley hated doing Blade?
Blade 3?
Or Blade 3. And why? How would you hate being Blade? That was the coolest.
Yeah, Triple H was on Bernie Mac. It was Bernie Mac's son went into his Rolodex and found that he was friends with Triple H, so he would call him.
Really?
And he would just ask Triple H random questions. And so he'd be like, they'd like watch a football game and they'd be talking about it. And then eventually Bernie Mac finds out, and then Triple H is like at the house cooking dinner with him, and he's going to like beat up his little son or nephew,
great.
Whatever.
That's great.
But before I ask him about this, I think I need to watch it again. The only thing I remember is that his first words were, oh, fuck.
Yeah, yeah.
He just screams the F word so loud.
Well, I'm pretty sure he gets stabbed in the eye, so it's warranted.
Yeah.
Did you ever see the Underworld movies?
Yes. I know I saw the first one. I think I saw the second one, but I'm not sure.
Oh, great movies. Great movies. Yeah. Underworld, Resident Evil? Mm. You seen all the Resident Evils?
No.
Wow.
No, I've seen
those are good
first two.
They're good. Worth watching.
Oh, no. So according to Patton Oswalt, Snipes just stayed in his trailer the whole time, smoked, and yelled at the director. Maybe he was going through something.
I mean, maybe that could be around tax time.
Yeah, that could have been.
You know, when Wesley was going to jail.
Yeah. All right, are we good for a game?
Yes, I got three in here.
Okay.
Starting the lobby up. We'll see who we got. We got Shattered in here.
Shattered and Voodoo. Perfect. Those are two people we need.
Okay. Who else?
We going family or victims?
We can go victims. I feel like we gotta redeem ourselves a little bit.
Are you think we will?
No. I mean, maybe. Who knows?
All right. Let's see.
Silent Hill. I feel like Silent Hill could have been way better.
Yeah.
They put one movie out and it just wasn't that good. Also, same with Assassin's Creed. They put out one movie and it just was like, it could be so good. Essentially, yeah. What they did with like The Last of Us, making the TV show. Like, you could do that with Silent Hill or Resident Evil or what were we just talking about? Silent Hill.
Yeah. Oh, should we? Oh, we can't spectate, can we? Unless should we let? Is it too much to let Voodoo and Shatter do a one-on-one?
Will we be able to watch?
Yeah, if we can still be in, but if one of them gets out or one of them like if Shatter, we'll try to find Shatter and Shatter can just kill us.
Oh, okay, yeah, I'm okay with that.
Okay.
Shattered as Leatherface, Voodoo as okay,
Leland.
Yeah. I'm cool with it.
Shattered. Breeze and I will just go to Leatherface's
room. Just get slaughtered. We won't have to exactly. We'll get slaughtered.
Yeah. And then it's Voodoo versus Shattered, one-on-one. I don't know who's got the advantage.
What should have been a night of memories and celebration.
I don't know. That's tough.
Scene one witness described.
Both are very good.
On Earth, teenage teenagers at Dutton High School
see the
were celebrating
movie?
An otherwise yes. uneventful senior good. Dance when two local men
okay.
identified as
43-year-old
Get
Her Alive movies.
Ooh, I think I saw one.
Because Kevin Nash is in it.
I think I saw one.
Yeah.
But I definitely have not seen however many there are.
Okay. I'm going to run into the other
Final
places.
Fantasy? This Final Fantasy? Are you with me here?
We just fell down?
Yeah.
I'm thickums.
Yep. Stop for a second.
I'm in Leatherface's room.
Yep. I'm with you. I'm curious, Lev.
Which maybe this gives Voodoo the advantage because Bro's gonna come kill us.
If you are, he definitely gets a little bit of a head start.
Yeah.
But you are
got it.
Alright, one on one screen.
Okay, let's see. No screen peeking.
No screen peeking. Who are you watching?
You can only watch Voodoo Child.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
You got eyes on Voodoo.
Wait, can I use that?
So yeah, I don't know who has the advantage here because
I don't know.
Nobody has help.
Uh-oh.
A lot of map
Uh-oh.
To cover.
Uh-oh.
Voodoo, you better move your ass, dude.
Voodoo knows. Voodoo just juked him out. Maybe. Oh, with the punch. Got a punch in.
Punched him. Punched his ass.
Got a punch.
Long shard, baby.
Uh-oh. But Voodoo's tired.
Voodoo's tired and punched him. Ooh, this is good.
Yeah.
This is good strategic play here.
Yeah. Okay.
You are brazen.
Wow.
Just hacking away at it.
Oh
my god, these two are good. These two are good, dude. They are way better than us.
Oh yeah. Oh, took off.
Behind you, son.
I don't know if they need to take advice from us.
Yeah, definitely not. We should just watch.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Oh.
Oh, my God. Dude, they know the maps or something. Like,
yeah.
They are just... If he goes here, he goes... They're running face-to-face on almost everything. Oh, you don't have time.
What?
You don't have time for this.
What?
Dude.
Uh-huh.
You don't have time for this. Oh, you're a lunatic. You're a lunatic.
Oh, for the Cuban Pete of the week.
Run that quick circle. Did he get a hack in?
No.
Ooh, a little bit.
Looking him side to side. Make another face work.
These guys are good.
Man.
Voodoo and Shattered were definitely who we should be.
Oh, yeah. Dude, I love a one-on-one.
This is... Especially, too, because they know exactly where each other are right now.
Do you think in a one-on-one, Leatherface is the best family member, or do you think you need somebody faster?
I think... So, Leatherface has to be...
They're gone.
He has to be present, right?
Oh, does he?
Yeah.
Okay.
If you ever did one-on-one, it has to be Leather.
Oop.
But is he the best? I don't know.
Uh-oh, here we go. Oh, wow.
Whoa!
Oh, wow.
Smart?
But why?
Is that smart?
Yeah.
Is it?
But we don't say it because if Leatherface is watching, then it'll give some information.
True.
Oh, wow.
Oh, God.
Maybe
oh,
not
God.
Smart. Oh, that's scary. That's
I don't
so
know if
scary.
That's smart.
That's so scary.
Dude, what are you doing? You're gonna get hacked alive.
Oh, no.
What is he doing?
I need help.
No. Wait, so did he just use Leather to open up that door, maybe?
No, I think that, well, I want to say afterwards. Wow.
That worked?
Wow.
Oh, it didn't work.
Got him. Oh, and his body parts all fell apart.
Oh, his head fell off.
The hunt is over.
Shattered by Cuban Pete of the Week. I gotta say, I'm surprised at the jumping out the window.
So I figured that it was a jump out the window now so that he can jump out the window later without a sound.
You might be right.
So tonight's Cuban Pete of the Week. Shattered Mind 20. Give it up for Shattered.
There you go. Voodoo, was that what you were trying to do?
And then give it up for Voodoo, too.
Is that what you were trying to do? Jump out the window and then jump out the window again? Do it like a little rinse and repeat?
Yeah, let us know. We need to learn the strats.
Yeah. Because he hacked away at that door and then would do a loop and then would come back to it.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking he did the same thing, like you said, out the window.
That's what I would imagine, but we're not good at this game, so. I said you were a great adversary. So yes, congrats, big congrats to our Cuban Pete of the Week. Thank you guys so much for being here. I did see somebody in the chat say that we could do a Fortnite lobby. A no build Fortnite lobby.
I'm okay with that because the build is rough. The build is rough. But I do enjoy the actual game.
Yeah. So maybe we do that next week.
I'm okay with that.
Yeah. Okay. We'll run that next week.
Goal is to jump out. Jump out, turn the generator off quick. But the recovery time got him. Yeah, the recovery time's rough. And also, Leather was like fast on you, dude. Like, he knew exactly where you're going. You got out that door and he was right behind you immediately.
And that's a scary thing to see. Just a field of like roses and Leatherface running at you with a chainsaw overhead. Jeez.
It was tough though. You did get away from him for a second and snuck right back out the door.
Yeah.
But I feel like he knew. Like he knew.
Yeah, that was good. We got to do Lethal Company at some point.
What is Lethal Company?
That's the one where you're like on a team and it's a horror game where you're like working in a factory or something.
Okay.
Yeah, but it's like we need like two more people.
Okay, I'm cool with Lethal Company.
Yeah, so.
But Fortnite, we can do next week.
Yeah, that's an easy one to do. But, okay, but thank you guys. Appreciate you for being here, Tuesday Night Heat. If you wouldn't mind helping us out a little bit, hit that like button. You're still here. If you enjoyed yourself tonight, if you got to play, have a good time, making friends in the chat, all type of stuff. And we'll see you Thursday for Battle of the Brands, per usual. And if you missed it, we have the Up Up Down Down Championship back in play. We had a Rock Paper Scissors tournament, and bit my lip. Jeez,
too many Oreos.
So many. Yeah, I'm just plowing through.
Dry mouth.
We had stuff set up for the holidays at Raw. People wearing Christmas sweaters. So I said, you know what? We need the title back in the mix. Let's run a Rock Paper Scissors tournament. Get something going, get the title back on a contender, and now we will get back to the games.
Oh, yeah.
The Baze is our current Up Up Down Down champion. And so she
don't like that.
Well, I mean, that's what happens.
But I don't like that, so.
We'll see if we do anything about it.
I'll do something about it. hey, Shane, how that body feeling?
So now we've got that back in the mix. You got some more things to look forward to here on the channel. We got a couple save points cooking for you guys, so we'll be flushing those out fairly soon. Happy New Year, 2024, off to a great start. Breeze, you got anything for the people?
We got lots cooking, like Creed said. We got lots. Mm-hmm. We got lots going. We got some other stuff on YouTube. We got some Fanatics Live stuff going on. Make sure you're following us, notifications. We'll give you a heads up on stuff that we do too, but we like to drop some surprise stuff too. So make sure you hang out with us, have some fun. Because 2024 is the year that we're in now. Sounds insane. Sounds crazy to me.
Oh, jeez.
Sounds crazy.
It is crazy. Where can they find you on socials?
Gorgeous 3Ms.
Nice. At Austin Creed Wins for myself, at Up Up Down and Without the O's for the channel on all social platforms. Thank you guys again for being here. Thank you guys for being super active in the chat. Congrats to our Q and Pete week shattered. Great job. Most importantly, everybody, make sure you remember to always and forever keep it tight. Good night.